came to the end. It seems you had heard, as we walked the city streets, you never said a word. When we finally sat down, your eyes were full of spite. I was desperate, I was weak, I could not put up a fight. But where are you now? Where are you now? Do you ever think of me in the quiet, in the crowd? Strangely less in pain than you were cold, triumphant in your mind of the logic that you hold. You said no one would ever know the love that we had shared. As I took my leave to go, it was clear you didn't care.
Let's explore that a little bit. What is the role of the teacher anyway?
Well, I think the role of the teacher is changed to the from the giver of information to the partner and the coach and the guide. And specifically, I think that the students are much better at doing the creating, the finding, the putting together, using the technology even at this stage. And the teacher's role then becomes the more important one of asking the right questions, of the quality and the rigor control, of the context providing. And on that respect, I have I call it an apostasy, because a lot of people don't agree with it. I don't know whether you will. I say that teachers don't need to learn how to create with the technology in order to teach effectively if they don't want to. If they want to, that's fine. But the kids can do that. They want to do that. So if you know what the technology does, and you can say to the kids, take it away, and then judge whether they've done a good job, that's a good role for the teacher.
I do agree with you. And I mean, one thing's for sure, we need teachers, we need good teachers, and when you put good teachers into the mix, you get better learning. There's no doubt about that, I think. But the analogy I often use is with a skateboard. You know, a kid comes past on a skateboard, and they jump, and the skateboard comes off the deck and spins in a pretty cool way, you know. The teacher might be able to make an observation about elasticity, about Newton's laws, maybe third law, you know, equal and opposite. There's a lot you can say about the physics of that. Mm-hmm. Teacher gets on the skateboard, they're going to break their neck, you know. So they can be great teachers, and they can bring a subject insight to this or a general insight, but they don't have to be good at skateboard. They have to be good with technology, and I think that's true. But above all else, I think we need teachers to be brave in all this, because they've got to trust the children. And they've got to be ambitious for the children, and that means being brave. You know, our systems, our inspection systems, our measurement systems are so unimaginative that little tiny bits of progress are seen as enough. We live in this curse of incrementalism and managerialism, where a little is seen as good. You know, if we're ambitious enough for kids, we see stellar, absolutely. You've seen the stuff that just the kids are.
You set the bar really high for them, and they reach for it. And one of the things that everybody feels fear, we all feel fear when we have to do more things that we don't understand, but feeling the fear and doing it anyway is the definition of courage.
Yes.
You have to feel the fear. And so not only do we have to have the courage to do it, as you say, but also encourage our colleagues to do that. Yes. Give them the courage to do that.
That's very nice, and maybe help our ministers and policymakers with that too. You know? What the teachers need to be, they need to be great lobbyists in helping our ministers to be brave as well.
Yes, and also finding mutual respect with the kids is very important, is really saying we are all teachers and we are all students. And some schools have even adopted that as their motto.
I do think that blurring is really important. I think, you know, our teachers are going to be lifelong learners, have to be, and we see that with the best teachers now. And some of our good children make excellent teachers. One of the great insights of the whole ICT and learning was how good children could be as teachers given the right context. So there's a nice blurring, what I call the in-betweeny space, you know, where it's kind of interesting because it's not regulated. You know, we inspect teachers for their teaching, we inspect learners for their learning, but nobody inspects learners for their teaching, nobody inspects teachers for their learning. So there's a little kind of wild west of freedom in the middle. That in-betweeny space is really exciting, you know. Mm-hmm. Courage, yeah, absolutely.